Murdering mediocrity are the two words that grabbed my attention when I came across Shilpa's profile. She helps people stuck in their careers snap out of it with speed and step into powerfully euphoric careers. She's a game-changing career coach and a proud member of Forbes Coaches Council. In fact, she is the Women Entrepreneur of the Year 2021 and also winner of Indian Achievers Award for this year 2021. Quite a lot of accomplishments. A quick snapshot of the results that she and her team have enabled. Successful career transitions with 100% increase in salary and job jumps with about 40 to 100% increase in salary. Promotions in just 1 to 4 months and successful parallel business along with the job. In today's episode, let's learn more about Shilpa's journey in becoming a sought-after coach and also get her insights on snapping out of the average game and becoming highly sought after. Hello. Hi there. Welcome to the Guiding Voice podcast series, The Guiding Voice for a Better Future. This podcast is to help professional students, IT employees, and entrepreneurs to shape their careers. If you have tuned into our podcast for the first time, you have missed a lot of stuff. But don't worry. All our previous episodes are available on your favorite podcast listening platform and also on YouTube. Just search for The Guiding Voice. Also, if you have not rated our podcast on Apple, please provide your rating and leave a positive review, because every rating and review will motivate us to bring in more content to you. Also, if you haven't subscribed to our channel on YouTube, please go ahead and subscribe to our channel. This is your host, Naveen Samala, and I have about 18 years of rich and diverse industry experience. So folks, in every episode, we interact with industry experts or thought leaders or academicians our coaches across the globe to drive some insightful conversations that will help each one of you learn some amazing things. You'll acquire more knowledge per every minute than any other podcast in this space. Also, we share an interesting trivia or a fun fact about the IT world or technology towards the end. So stay tuned till the end. Thank you so much for tuning in. So folks, today we are going to discuss a topic, snapping out of the average game and becoming highly sought after. And we're pleased to have Shilpa part of TGV's journey in shaping the careers and lives of millions across the globe. Shilpa, welcome to TGV.
Thanks so much, Naveen. It's an honor to be here on your show.
Pleasure hosting you, Shilpa. Shall we get started?
Absolutely.
Wonderful. So Shilpa, you have an amazing and inspiring career journey. Like, I was going through your LinkedIn profile and I was literally impressed because the kind of setbacks that you had and all. But still, you have fought back and you became a most sought-after coach. Can you share with our audience on how you faced those odds and reached your current position? And when you do that, please highlight top 2 or 3 attributes that help you become what you are today.
Sure. So it all started, Naveen, when I had been in my career with some of the best companies, Deloitte, Tech Mahindra, Westpac. I had a wonderful stint, or so I thought, of 16 years with them. And what happened was, 3 years back, September 2018, I was working on an initiative which was to change the structure in Westpac, which was the company that I worked for at that time. I was working there for 9 years. And I came to know that as a result of that restructure, my position had become redundant. Now, this one was a big surprise for me, a big surprise, because all these years I thought that I was outstanding. But in that moment, reality struck me. Only those people are asked to go who are not playing their A game. And the fact was, I wasn't. So I was there on the road thinking about, where did I go wrong? From a school topper, a national level ranker, a gold medalist, where did I slip? And I realized that somewhere in between, I had become a mediocre. I had slipped into what I call an average game. So I said, okay, let me take a pause. Let me sit back and connect with myself. Who am I today? After 16 years of such a busy profile, work projects after projects, companies after companies, and where am I going? I packed my bags and I started traveling around the world, learning from the best coaches in the world. And in that journey somewhere, I started connecting with myself, pieces of me whom I had lost in that fast life that I had been part of. And I started discovering my strengths. I started getting answers to what is it that I truly like. Till that point, I had not actually exercised my choice. I had just picked up what life had thrown at me. A lot of people would have heard about going with the flow. So I had gone with the flow and life had thrown me all kinds of average stuff. I had grabbed it And I kept working on that. And at that point, I realized, no, I need to choose this time, first time, what I want. And then I started working on something that I really enjoyed as part of my corporate career, which is enabling people to grow in their careers. I realized that about 80% of the people around, they are mediocres, just like I had been. And because I knew the mistakes that I had made, and because I had received the best coaching from the experts across the world, I started holding their hands, helping them get out of that mediocre zone to what I call the power zone. And obviously, the journey was not, I wouldn't say it was rosy to start with. Right now, when we look back, it looks like it was awesome, but there were so many ups and downs. There were points where our finances drained, when nothing was working out, when I didn't know how to sell myself. I knew I could create results, but I didn't know how to stand in the market and say, pay me for what I'm worth for. But three things that helped me was, one, my belief system. So all those years, 16 years, when I stayed a mediocre, my belief system was just this much, just small, just little, and that's what I produced. But in these last 3 years, my belief system has expanded. I believe that I can create anything and I can do so much more than what I was doing. So one is my belief system. I really worked on it to create the results for others. Secondly, leveraging others. So even though I am a coach, I have a coach. And I think that worked like wonders. That cut short my journey, which could have taken 10 years, into 10 months. I was creating amazing results with the people across the globe. And the third thing is action. I realized this magic of actions. Even if it is right, it is wrong, it doesn't matter. It is about taking massive actions. So this is what brought me from, I would say, a nobody sitting in a corner desk in a corporate, in a big company, to somebody who is working with people across 13 countries, helping them step into their power zones and creating extraordinary results.
That's a quite a lot of inspiring stuff. In fact, you touched upon a lot of aspects in terms of, you know, becoming somebody from nobody. Very, very inspiring. And the three things that you mentioned is more about expansion of the belief system, leveraging the network, and having a coach. Though you are a coach, you are relying on your coach to get better and better. And most important one is about the actions. I think those are some amazing and wonderful insights. So thank you for sharing that. Talking about today's topic, like when we were having that discussion, why did you propose this topic, snapping out of the average game? So what is the motivation behind that?
Motivation is my own life, Naveen. So the pain that I have gone through, and I didn't realize it at that point of time. I was somebody who barely existed in the company meetings. I was somebody who didn't have a voice. I was good one-on-one, but no public speaking. I was an introvert to the core, and it took away a good part of my life from me. And when I realized that there's something, it's not others. A lot of times we think we have a bad manager, we have got a toxic culture, company that we are part of, the culture is such that no growth can happen, but it is always us. So I realized that it is our responsibility. Whatever quality of life we are living today, we have created it. It's 100% responsibility. Yes, there might be things that life throw at you and you have to respond to it, but how you respond to it is again your responsibility. So if we can be rock solid to the core, if we can work on the foundation level, that mediocrity, we can absolutely get rid of it. And it is ordinary people like us. Like yesterday, I couldn't even believe that I would be doing this. Today, my manager's manager and his manager, they come and do my programs. I couldn't have even thought about this yesterday. So everything is possible. And people, ordinary people like us, do the extraordinary things. So with that principle in mind, I know mediocrity, a lot of people are going through. And the worst part is they don't even know that they are going through. I didn't know that until circumstances jolted me up. I was made redundant. And then I took that opportunity to see what had gone wrong. But mostly mediocres, they are able to survive till the last day, till the day of the retirement. There's no survival issue. So they can be caught in that forever. But if they identify it and if they decide to snap out of it, you know, there's no limit. So that's why this topic is really close to my heart, because I see people, ordinary people who come to me and they get promotion, not one promotion, but three promotions in a year. Isn't that amazing? Like those people who have been stuck for 5 years, they get three promotions in a year. This is really amazing, mind-boggling.
Absolutely. Who would really not want to get promoted thrice in an year? And this is again quite an inspiring journey. So from being an introvert and who is not clear, now being on the other side of the table and trying to shape the lives and careers of people across 30 different countries. Quite a lot of inspiring stuff. Let me cheer this conversation and move on to the next question, Shilpa. Why do you think people are stuck at the average?
They're stuck in the average because somehow from the day we are born, like we come to this world not knowing what we are made for. Society starts conditioning us in a certain manner. We are told to go to the best school. We are told to perform the best in all the subjects. We are told that grades matter. Then the moment we finish a school or even before that, the pressure starts of joining a great uni, engineering, medical, CA. And now the time has changed. There are so many other opportunities that are coming up, so many other subjects. But the pressure is the same. You want to get a good job and settle down. That's when you are considered settled down. But what happens in that process is somewhere you tend to pick up the things that you have no idea about and you really don't want, but you don't give yourself time to think about, is this my choice? Is this what I want? What is my high level direction? You never actually think about it. And mostly people reach their 40s and they realize that we are not doing what we actually want. And at that point, their job becomes monotonous, non-juicy. They consider it as a 9-to-5 thing. They go, they do it as a mechanical thing, and they come back, realizing over the years that it is not giving them the fulfillment. So it is really important for us to realize that somewhere in this process, we are pushed into an average game. And I'll give you an example, Naveen. My daughter, she's in year 11. And for the last 1 year, she knows that she doesn't want to do those subjects at school. And she's brilliant. She has made it to the top schools here in Australia where only 1% of the students go. So there's no question of brilliance. That's not her choice. She doesn't want to study history, which she feels has no relevance today. And she doesn't want to spend her time on maths because she doesn't think that it gives her juices. So this year, we decided that she will step into what she loves, which is making a difference to the world. And she has joined my business as a coach, a 16-year-old, and she's coaching the people who are 3 times her age. So this kind of choice was not given to us and was not given to me.
I think those are such a profound statements, like you have brought in the reality, okay, that is existing in today's society, right? It's about conditioning and everybody wants to start with the great schools or the best schools. And also once they get into that school, the grades matter. And think about only 3 career choices, either engineering, medical or CA. But I'm really amused when you mentioned that your daughter has already become a coach, so which is again quite inspiring. And also you touched upon this midlife crisis, right? Probably in case if we have to avoid this midlife crisis, maybe we need to do a constant introspection, as you rightly mentioned, make time to think about, are you happy with what you are doing? Okay, keeping aside the money aspects and all. Great. And so that you can also start making a difference in your life and then realize your dreams. Such a set of great thoughts shared so far. Now, let me move on to my next question. Now that if at all someone has identified, hey, I'm stuck at the average, how do I snap out of that average game and get into that power zone, as you mentioned?
That's really wonderful if somebody has identified, I'm in the mediocre zone, I'm stuck in the average, and I need to snap out of it. A lot of people will ask, can I do it myself? Yes, you can. There's nothing that you can't do. It's just that it will take more time. So as I mentioned, like it took me a year to get to, if I talk in terms of the figures, to get to making the impact that I was making, working with about 100 people in that 1 year. And also getting to 5 times of my salary in terms of my business revenue. It took me just a year. This was because I had a coach and my coach has his coach, you know, practicing what we preach. Now, if you want to go on your own, you can do it. But I'll tell you what you need to work on. One is your belief system. There are some beliefs that you have that is limiting your progress. Yeah, and you need to really work on it to expand it, so that you can create something much bigger and much better. Secondly, you need to understand the patterns that you have living your life with. And this is where it gets much more difficult, because it is difficult for you to decouple yourself from your patterns. They have become so much a part of your life that it is very difficult to see which ones are obstructing your own forward movement. The best thing I would suggest is get somebody who has done it. Get in touch, buy their time, buy their experience, and take their help to understand the patterns that are obstructing your growth. get rid of those patterns. And obviously there's a method to the madness. And then, you know, find out what your strengths are. What are your core strengths? What is it that you have enjoyed? What is it that you have thought through all these years? The options that have been in front of you. It might be what you have already been doing or a subset of it or something completely different. It doesn't matter. But evaluate all the options and come up with one direction for your life. Just one direction, no backups, nothing. Just one direction, and then step into your power zone, which is what I call a flow state, where all those patterns have been broken, where your belief system has expanded. And then keep moving towards that with absolute clarity, absolute certainty, confidence, and courage.
Wow, simply amazing. First of all, understand what is limiting your progress, probably by breaking the belief system and understand the patterns. Maybe we can seek the help of a coach. While we do that, understand or identify the core strengths and focus on one direction. Then you'll step into power zone. Thank you for sharing those tips again. Now let's talk about second part of today's topic. From seeking out to becoming highly sought after. What are your tips to those who want to become highly sought after? Especially I see these folks in the middle level management who have that struggle in terms of breaking that glass ceiling and getting into that and becoming a highly sought after. What are your tips to those audience?
Absolutely. So the first part that we talked about is getting rid of the things that are dragging you down. What happens is most of the time people are looking for becoming highly sought after, getting that job, that promotion, double promotion, making career transitions, getting 100% salary increase. But we forget that we have not, your legs are tied. So first step is unchaining yourself from those belief systems, all those things that we mentioned, patterns and your experiences that have kept you where you are. Once you've unchained that, then it is a matter of going out there and playing in the dirt, playing in the mud. Be 100% visible. Leave all those inhibitions. And it is, I know it's easier said than done. That's what is required. So initially, it is a push effect that you have to do on the market. You have to push yourself a little bit. You have to make efforts in getting in touch with the right people, creating the right visibility, being 100% authentic and standing there telling that this is who I am and this is what I bring to the table. And slowly that push effect start getting converted into a pull effect where people start approaching you. And this is, Naveen, what happens with a lot of my clients. So one of my clients, we were not even looking for a job for him. He had just joined my coaching program 2 months before, and he was literally scooped up. And I use this word scooped up because I feel so proud of it. He was literally scooped up from LinkedIn by somebody whom he had worked with a few years back for a job which was 55% more than his current salary. So that happened with him, and literally day before yesterday. So he joined that job, and in a few months, day before yesterday, 11:30 a.m. Sydney time is when he attended the interview. 3:30 p.m. is when he sent me the offer letter that he received. So this is what happens when you become so attracted that you become a magnet for opportunities. And it happens all the time. Another client of mine, she was doing a career transition from one area to a completely different area. She made herself so knowledgeable. She made herself so attractive in that area that she was picked up at 100% more salary reporting to the CEO. So make yourself totally visible, bare yourself to the bone. I'm not saying be somebody whom you are not, just be very comfortable with who you are. Be yourself, but better yourself every single day and stand there. The right people will get attracted to you.
Wow, those are some wonderful, amazing real life examples. And you made a profound statement, be yourself, but better yourself every day. Great. Thank you so much for sharing those. Shilpa, here comes a general question. Now that you have faced a lot of odds and you were able to demonstrate that resiliency and stand out in such a powerful zone, okay, where you have become a lead magnet in terms of getting the clients and also helping them shape their careers and lives, so on and so forth. So how do you think people can deal with these unforeseen challenges like you faced, like when you were part of the restructuring, but that restructuring has become a nightmare for you, right? Which was completely unexpected. And any secrets, Sas, that you'd like to share with the audience in terms of dealing with unforeseen challenges?
Unfortunately, there's no secret sauce, Naveen. Requires is a great mindset. You may not have the resources. Like, life will always throw those curveballs at you. You can really never plan life. Even if you plan, it will surprise you with something else. So what is required is for you to be not reacting to it. When we react to it, that's where we lose the game. The key is in responding powerfully to it. And for that powerful response, we need to build powerful minds. That is important. Again, I'll take you to a time in my life when I started this coaching and I was a few months, you know, initial 3-4 months into the business, and it was not working out. Things were not working. Word of mouth was there. Results were being created, but it was really slow. So I was not at all making enough to pay my expenses. And my husband had also jumped into the business just a couple of months before me. So it was not working out for the family. 2 dependent daughters, 1 daughter in year 12, which means that it was a crucial year. And the business not working out. We don't have a job. So it was easy for us to say, okay, let one of us go back to the job. And we did think about it, honestly. I would lie if I would say I didn't. We thought about it, but then it was like, we have jumped into this, not to go back. And we said, we'll do everything that is required for us to keep going, not going on our own. We still had a coach and we were paying him. I don't know how much guts we had. We were still paying him. We were still learning from the best coaches around the world, but we were broke. So what we did was we took a hardship allowance from the bank so that mortgage payments can stop. We took a big loan from our friends. It was a huge sum, and we were lucky to have people who believed in us. And thirdly, Naveen, and this would surprise you, where I'm sitting, there's a wall in front of me. We built a wall. This is in the middle of our living room. One day we just got up in the morning and we decided, what is it that we can do that we can pay our grocery bills for the week? So we built this wall with our own hands, and we gave a portion of the house to Airbnb. And the money that we got from there, it kept feeding into our grocery bills for a good number of months. So it was not that we had enough resources, but we knew what was important. Important was to keep going, not give up. Important was not to be on our own, but to have the right helping hands, the coach. Important was not to spend on unnecessary things like eating out. Even spending $10 was a big no for us. But spending $10,000 on a coach was important. For that, we borrowed money and we kept going. So what I mean to say is, life will throw circumstances that you least expect. But what you need to do is to respond to that powerfully. That's where most of the people go to a certain extent. They try and try and try, but at a point, they just leave. But it is just a little bit more. If you can do just a little bit more, that's where you win it.
So 2 things that stuck my mind when you were talking about how to deal with this kind of unforeseen situations. First thing is, have a great mindset. Never get bogged down. And second one is respond but not react. Because if we react, probably we will not be in a state to make right decisions and all. Such a profound statement. So Shilpa, this conversation has been very wonderful. And a lot of inspiring stuff that you have shared. And in fact, it really is very evident that you need to have a coach, okay, in your life to be able to move forward and meet your own career dreams. So audience, right now, you can find Shilpa's LinkedIn profile as well as her website details in the show notes. Go ahead and connect with her and probably embark on your career transformation. So that being said, Shilpa, I would like to add some spice to this episode by asking you a few interesting rapid-fire questions. I'm going to ask you a few interesting questions and probably you can answer them very briefly, 2-3 words or maximum 1 phrase. If you are ready, well, let's get started.
Yes, let's do it.
Wonderful. Thank you for the spirit. So Shilpa, you had a very, very inspiring career journey so far and a lot of transformation, lots of ups and downs and all. So I'm really curious to know, which movie would you relate your life to?
Chak De.
Wow, great. Let me move on to the next question. What is your favorite movie dialogue that stuck with you for a long time?
Same with Chak De. Wo 70 minute tumhare paas hain. Achha khelo, bura khelo. You will always remember it.
Wow. I think that's a very good movie. In fact, very inspiring. And the way our hockey team girls have pulled up this time was also very inspirational. And everybody recollected about Chak De movie. Yeah. Let me move on to the next question out of the rapid fire. What is the hidden talent that no one knows about you, Shilpa?
I'm pretty good with the things people hate, the ingredients, and I can convert them into awesome recipes, healthy recipes.
Great. Interesting to know. All right, let me move on to the next question. What has been a question on your mind for which you never got an answer for?
Why ordinary? why do we choose the ordinary when we can be extraordinary?
Wow, simply amazing. Okay, the last one for the rapid fire. What is one message that you like to give to your own younger version?
Don't tolerate mediocrity, because when you do, it lingers on. You get more of it.
Great. I think there has been a lot of focus on murdering mediocrity. This is such an inspiring conversation. And thank you so much for being so sport in the rapid fire round. With that, let me flip back to the mainstream and ask you one final question for this session. What will be your one piece of advice to those aspiring to make big in their careers?
What I would say is, firstly, get a coach if you can. And if, you know, if that's a problem, I would say work on your mindset. That is the magic behind anything, whether it is promotion, whether it is setting up a business, becoming an entrepreneur, creating a side income, getting promotions, getting jobs, getting career, making career transitions. Mindset is the key. We underestimate this word so much, but it is this what keeps you going. This is the one which enables you to take actions. This is the one which pushes you and makes you get stuck. So work on the mindset. Powerful mindset is the basis of every super successful person in this world. So that's the secret ingredient, as you asked Naveen earlier. If you can work on it, you will learn one core principle: give up giving up. And that is the key to your success.
Wow. This has been a fantastic conversation. Thank you so much for joining me today. And it was a great topic to talk about, snapping out of the average game and move into the power zone, at the same time become highly sought after. Thank you so much once again for being part of TGV's journey in shaping the lives and careers of millions across the globe.
Thank you so much, Naveen. It was an absolute pleasure and an honor.
Thank you. So pleasure is ours, and definitely would like to invite you again in future to cover many more episodes and inspire our audience. All right. So folks, let's move on to the trivia segment of today's episode. And today's trivia is about BMW, one of the most sought after car brands in the world today. So here comes my question. What do the initials BMW stand for? I know you're thinking, but let me tell you the secret as per the ritual. It is Bavarian Motor Works. So folks, here comes a bonus question for this episode. Which company uses the tagline, the ultimate driving machine? I know you're thinking, but let me reveal it again. It is the same BMW company, uses the tagline, the ultimate driving machine. Interesting, isn't it? Thank you so much for tuning in. There's more in store, folks. Stay tuned. Take care. Be safe. Until next time. Bye-bye. And we are signing off for today. See you all in the next episode with another wonderful guest.